I feel like every episode I give you is a gift. Praying at the speed of love is a gift. It's a gift to me. It's a gift to be able to do this. It's a gift to be able to read these books and then to be able to sit here in conversation with people I adore and have my heart opened and opened and opened and opened. But this conversation, number 24, you know what 24 is? 24 in sign language, 24. It's a six, right? 2 + 4 = 6.
That's right.
You know what a six is? Just look at it. I learned this from my dear friend, Emma, the numerologist. Just look at that six. Just look at that six. It's a pregnant woman. You want to get pregnant with love? You want to get pregnant with prayer? Here it is with Dr. Neil Douglas-Klotz. And this is the original cover of a book that Matthew Fox, who I adore, called A Revolution. Now, a revolution of prayer, would you not be interested? I have had this book, oh, this treasure on my bookshelf for years. And today we get to have a conversation with Dr. Neil Douglas-Klotz, but the conversation is really with this man. This mystical teaching from the Middle East, mystical teacher from the Middle East. We hear his name in English as Jesus of Nazareth, but his words, his name is not what we hear in English. So Neil and I have just had this outrageous, I haven't really recovered. I'm still vibrating with these Aramaic words in my body. So Neil, tell everybody and give us a little taste of this, I don't know, hour and 15 minutes or so that we just had with Jesus.
I think we had sort of like prayer jazz, is what I mentioned during the conversation, Janet. And that, you know, we were doing theme and improvisations on what prayer really is. And Jesus was one of the players. I don't know if he was playing saxophone or trombone or whatever, but this mystic that we call Jesus, who's, as you mentioned, his real Aramaic name means Yeshua or Yahshua. And it means, you know, ever living life helps us fulfill our purpose, you know, and ever living life is all around us. So, I think we were talking about, we're talking about really Agun. That's the first word of the prayer. And that's the word that echoes down through the whole conversation. It has to do with the breath that comes from the source that's coming into and through us right now, which is, I think what you're all about, you know. Prayer is what's coming through your breath and coming through you right now. It that opens the heart towards some greater reality. And it's also very creative in life. It's inspiring. It helps us, you know, discover what is really ours to do. So I think those were big themes that we had, really.
And it's just so full of beauty. It's so full of beauty. The truth is that if you were raised saying this prayer that I was told was called the Our Father, or you might have heard it as the Lord's Prayer, in this conversation, right from the get-go, there goes that. You cannot translate Avund Bashmaya as Our Father. Well, surprise, Matthew's right. This is a revolution, but it's a revolution of love. One of the first things you said is about prayer, which is a word I adore. And you said, you must separate prayer from religion. Prayer has nothing to do with religion. Right there. What's that little phrase? You had me at hello. Prayer is completely, has nothing to do with religion. Wow.
Yeah, religion comes from prayer. Prayer doesn't come from religion. So, but prayer doesn't have to lead to religion. You know, it's like saying, you know, an artist to create has to go to a gallery. It doesn't make sense. Yeah, people are creative. We create because we are human beings who are creative. So prayer is creative. But doesn't mean you have to put everything you make and make money from it in a gallery. That's what religion does to prayer. Excuse the metaphor. Religion is important for people. It's supposed to bring people together. The Latin word means to bring together, but so often it splits people from themselves and from each other. So it's, you know, it's, like I say, I don't want to get too far down on religion, but it's done a lot of damage. It still has the potential to do a lot of good, but it's going to have to step up or kneel down or something. I don't know.
So one of the great beauties in this conversation is Dr. Neil Douglas-Klotz takes each word and you will really enter the Aramaic sound. It's as if you're standing on a hillside in first century Palestine and hearing this magnificent teacher speak to you. And yes, Dr. Klotz introduces the translations. He's the greatest living translator of Jesus in the Aramaic. But what happens in this conversation is we bypass the mind and the breath, the words, the meaning, the vibration of love goes deeper and deeper, deeper into your body. I could not give you a greater gift than a conversation with Yeshua through the voice of Dr. Neil Douglas-Klotz on Praying at the Speed of Love, number 24. Come to janetconnor.com/24. And guess what? You will be pregnant with love.